We interrupt this program in order to bring you the following address from the President of the United States.
Good evening, my fellow Americans. As all of you are aware, exactly 1 week ago, the Chinese government seized and refused to surrender a U.S. Navy EP-3 surveillance plane, along with its crew of 24. What followed was 6 days of intense, round-the-clock negotiations with Chinese officials in an attempt to resolve this situation. Unfortunately, these efforts were unsuccessful. Finally, early this evening, I made a bold decision to meet with the Chinese President Jiang Zemin alone, one-on-one, no Dick Cheney, no State Department officials, no military advisors, no international law specialists, no China scholars, no translators. Just the two of us, face to face, mano a mano, and to keep at it until we work this thing out. That was the breakthrough. In less than 20 minutes, President Jiang and I had signed an agreement I'm proud to say that both averts an international crisis and leaves American honor and dignity intact. Here are its chief points. Number one, the United States government sincerely, profusely, and abjectly apologizes to China for this incident. It was entirely our fault, and we did a bad thing. Two, the Navy aircraft will be returned immediately following its complete disassembly and examination by North Korean intelligence. Three, upon its return to the U.S., the plane will be sold to the government of Libya, with all proceeds going to the Palestine Liberation Organization. Four, all secret documents found on board the aircraft will be surrendered to the United States. The Chinese will keep photocopies. Number five, for its part, the Chinese government has agreed not to share these photocopies with Iran, Iraq, or other rogue nations, although sharing photocopies of photocopies is permitted, provided they are readable. I fought hard for that one. Six, under no circumstances will photocopies of photocopies of photocopies be allowed. Seven, our 24 U.S. Navy servicemen and servicewomen, I'm happy to say, are already back on American soil. After a reunion with their families, they will be returned to China to begin serving their 90-day sentences for espionage at a Chinese labor camp. Number eight, Chinese President Jiang Zemin and his wife will have full use of the Bush Vacation Ranch in McAllen, Texas, from Memorial Day through Labor Day, with the exception of 4th of July weekend and 2 weekends in August. President Bush and Laura Bush will pay for utilities. Mr. Zhang will be responsible for pool maintenance. Point nine, General Colin Powell has agreed to resign as Secretary of State and to surrender his driver's license and credit cards. On June 1st, he will begin serving his sentence at a Chinese labor camp. 10. The Chinese government has agreed to officially designate the first week in August Ed Too Tall Jones Appreciation Week. 11. Yankees outfielder Daryl Strawberry will voluntarily enter a drug treatment facility. 12. Located where? In a Chinese labor camp. Number 12, don't mess with Texas. 13, don't ever mess with Texas. 14, live from New York, it's Saturday night!